In core mathematics, there are four little sections, C1, C2, C3, C4. In statistics, for A-level maths, all you need to worry about is statistics 1 and statistics 2. Similarly, for mechanics and decision, there are only two modules that you need to concern yourself with now. If you choose to do further mathematics, there are several more within those three applied areas that you'll need to consider. In order to gain an entire A level in mathematics, you must complete all the core modules to obtain a full A level. In your first year, so for those of you in year 12, you'll have to complete C1 and C2. And generally, when you get into year 13, you start doing C3 and C4. All examination papers are 90 minutes long for the year 12 ones and the year 13 ones. They're 90 minutes long. Core and statistics lead on quite smoothly from all the GCSE syllabi that we have in the UK. And those of you that are doing iGCSE will find that you'll know even more of the A-level module. When I'm talking about these syllabi, what I'm referring to is the Edexcel A-level mathematics modules. You can do AQA, there's an MEI one as well, which contain even more information. But generally in the UK, most students do the Edexcel modules, so we're going to be concentrating on what those modules consist of. For most of you, mechanics and decision mathematics will be completely new topics. Very few people would have covered these before they get into year 12 and year 13. And the A-level modules are quite good because they do introduce you to these two sections quite slowly. Okay, so let's have a look at the very first section that I mentioned, which is core mathematics. Core mathematics is lovely. It's pretty much most of what you've been doing at GCSE, but extended even further. It's one of my favourite areas of mathematics. It includes things like numerical methods. All that means is the stuff with numbers, nothing too fancy. Algebra, so things like quadratic equations, linear programming for those of you who've started doing that. Trigonometry, so that would be your SOHCAHTOA. You'll find in the area of a triangle using a half AB sine C, things like that. And the final thing is transformations. Transformations is probably the strangest topic out of those four. The transformation section refers to graphs, drawing them, working out the equation of them, as well as the four transformations that you've learnt at GCSE. Okay. So let's start with Core Mathematics 1. I'm going to go into quite a lot of detail about this particular module because this one's the one that you will meet first. Okay, it's quite a nice module. It doesn't allow you to use a calculator. So it's very important that the skills that you've learnt from your GCSEs about writing out all your working out, checking your answers over and over again, is followed through when you're doing your A-levels. The material in Core 1 overlaps a great deal of what you've done at GCSE. Then C2, C3 and C4 build upon what you've learnt in Core 1. So each time you continue to do one of these modules, you have got to make sure that you understand everything from the ones you've done before. I'll give you a piece of advice. A lot of students between year 12 and year 13 don't do a lot of revision over the summer holidays or don't try and recap what they've learnt already. I'd strongly advise you to spend a week in between the 2 years, so during that summer, just revising through your C1 and your C2. A lot of the students that I teach in my school who've done that are clearly more able to grasp the concept in C3 and C4. So please don't get lazy over the summer between the 2 years. With maths, it's very important that you continue to keep up your ability. What I'll do at the end of the session is go through a couple of questions to give you an idea of what you already know that can allow you to access the A-level module. For now, I'm going to continue going through the other subjects involved in it so that you can understand the whole concept in one go.